Thank you. The next item of business is the election of two deputy presiding officers. As previously announced, I have received four valid nominations. In alphabetical order, the nominations are Linda Fabiani, Kenneth Gibson, Christine Graham, and Margaret Mitchell. The election shall again proceed in accordance with Rule 11.9 of Standing Orders, with voting procedures the same as those used in the election of the presiding officer. If no member receives an overall majority in the first round of voting, there will be subsequent rounds. This procedure will also be followed for the election of the second deputy presiding officer. When the first deputy presiding officer is elected, voting rounds will begin for the second deputy presiding officer, involving all candidates who are unsuccessful in the election of the first deputy presiding officer. I hope you follow that. I now declare the election of the first deputy presiding officer open. Members should now proceed to the appropriate desk to collect their ballot papers.
Thank you.
Voting for this round of the Deputy Presiding Officer election is now closed. I would now invite any scrutineers appointed by the candidates to the back of the chamber to observe the counting of ballot papers. And candidates may also observe the count. Thank you. Thank you. In the first round of voting in the election of the Deputy Presiding Officer, the number of votes cast for each candidate was as follows. Linda Fabiani, 52 votes. Kenneth Gibson, 14 votes. Christine Graham, 19 votes. Margaret Mitchell, 36 votes. Accordingly, as no candidate has received an overall majority of the votes cast, and as Kenneth Gibson received the fewest votes, he is eliminated from the election, and a further round will take place with the following candidates: Linda Fabiani, Christine Graham, and Margaret Mitchell. There will now be a short break while new ballot papers are printed. I now suspend this meeting for 5 minutes. Members, you'll be pleased to hear the voting period is now open and using the same voting procedure as before. Can I just remind members that you're only voting for one candidate? There's one X, please. And I can also say to members that a number of members are missing, so there are 121 votes cast plus one spoiled paper last time. Thank you. You can please proceed to the back of the chamber. Members, voting for this round of the Deputy Presiding Officer election is now closed. I would invite the scrutineers to proceed to the back of the chamber for the count. Again, candidates may also observe the count. In this round of voting, in the election of the Deputy Presiding Officer, the number of votes cast for each candidate was as follows. For Linda Fabiani, 59 votes. For Christine Graham, 19 votes. For Margaret Mitchell, 46 votes. 124 votes cast in total. Now, no candidate has received an overall majority. So I'm going to the lowest number of votes for Christine Graham means that Christine Graham will be eliminated from the next round of voting. So, I'm now going to suspend Parliament for 5 minutes while we print off new ballot papers for the last two candidates. I suspend the Parliament for 5 minutes. Thank you. Voting for this round of the Deputy Presiding Officer election is now closed. I would invite the scrutineers to proceed to the back of the chamber for the count. And candidates may also...
No, we haven't voted.
You're opening one.
John Silver.
Sack the Presiding Officer.
Go back to number three.
I'll threaten you with a new election. That'll keep you... I now declare the election for the second Deputy Presiding Officer open. Voting procedures are the same as before. Please proceed to the back of the chamber.
The
first Deputy Presiding Officer. Please proceed to the back of the chamber and vote. Voting for this round of the Deputy Presiding Officer election is now closed. I would invite the candidates and the scrutineers to make their way to the back of the chamber. Thank you. Thank you. In this round of voting in the election of the Deputy Presiding Officer, the number of votes cast for each candidate was as follows. Linda Fabiani, 72 votes. Margaret Mitchell, 52 votes. Accordingly, as Linda Fabiani received more votes than the total number of votes received by the other candidate, and as more than 25% of members voted, Linda Fabiani is elected as Deputy Presiding Officer of the Scottish Parliament. Can I also offer my congratulations to our new Deputy Presiding Officer, and I look forward to working together over the next 5 years. Members will be delighted to hear that voting rounds will now begin for the second Deputy Presiding Officer, involving all the candidates who are unsuccessful in the election of the first Deputy Presiding Officer. There will be a short break while ballot papers are printed. I suspend the meeting for a few minutes. I now declare the election for the second Deputy Presiding Officer open. Voting procedures are the same as before. Members may now proceed to the back of the chamber to collect their papers. and candidates to proceed to the back of the chamber for the count. Thank you.
Thank you.
In the first round of voting in the election of the second Deputy Presiding Officer, the number of votes cast for each candidate was as follows. Kenneth Gibson, 24 votes. Christine Graham, 43 votes. Margaret Mitchell, 57 votes. Accordingly, as no candidate received an overall majority of the votes cast, and as Kenneth Gibson received the fewest votes, he is eliminated from the election and a further round will take place with the following candidates, Christine Graham and Margaret Mitchell. There will now be a short break while ballot papers are printed for the next round. I suspend Parliament for a few minutes. The voting period is now open and members may proceed to the back of the chamber to collect their ballot papers. this round of Deputy Presiding Officer has closed. I would invite the scrutineers and candidates to proceed to the back of the chamber. Thank you. In the second round of voting in the election for the second Deputy Presiding Officer, the number of votes cast for each candidate was as follows. Christine Graham, 65 votes. Margaret Mitchell, 58 votes, and there was one abstention. Accordingly, as Christine Graham received more votes than the total number of votes received by the other candidate, and as more than 25% of members voted, Christine Graham is elected as the second Deputy Presiding Officer for the Scottish Parliament. May I also offer my congratulations, and I look forward to working with both deputies as a team. Can I offer my thanks to all the candidates who have put their names forward today? And in fact, can I thank all members for their patience and fortitude? I would reassure members that this is a unique voting system, once every 5 years. However, colleagues may wish to note that the next meeting of the Parliament will be at 2 o'clock on Tuesday, the 17th of May, to select a nominee for the appointment of a First Minister, and voting will be by electronic ballot. The nomination period will begin at 9:30 a.m. on Tuesday, the 17th of May. I now close this first meeting of the fifth session of the Scottish Parliament.